okay, I've got to cut out this door area here. I've got the right width, so I'll deal with that now.
Motorists are being told to drive to condition. The WeatherZone's Brett Dutchke says they're...
Okay, so don't forget to line up all your joins vertically and horizontally so they all line up. That's very important. Don't forget to use some type of spacer and keep them separate, so in the future if you realize that your top tiles may be a little bit wider than your bottom tiles, that you've got a little bit of room for adjustment. Because this type of tile, the widths, they're not always exactly the same as I've said before, and I'll just stress again that the height is also sometimes differing. So next is this row along here. All I can do is just fill in along the top of the door. What has to happen is this heat lamp light and fan in one has to be wired up by the electrician. That probably won't happen until after Christmas. He has to run his wires down to the switch, and I have to leave this duct open and this area of the tiles off. Just from there, two tiles to, you know, the ends of the tiles. But this is the next job here. Okay, so that's the top row. So it's just this little section here to fill in the back wall.
So I've got 23mm.
Okay, that's it. All the tiles are on the wall, and that only leaves the grouting for the tiling work. So next week I'll get some grout and carry on. Unfortunately, over the two previous couple of nights, some animals come along and had a good feast on the ripe ones, but still plenty. Surprising to get them here, it's quite sandy and dry. 30th of the 11th, 2013. The bath, the shower base, they've all got thin protective cover. That's the cover there. You need to remove that away from the edge before you grout. So I've just used a small blade and I've cut along the edge and I've peeled back this. Now I'll just use a bit of sticky tape to hold it. Okay, I've made sure that everywhere, the vanity, around the mirror, and everywhere, this gap here, there's any tape removed from the wall. So all the edges are removed of any tape or any film, protective cover, all the way around the bath, the edge of the bath, and as I say, the vanity and the mirror covered. I've removed any markings that I used to write on the tiles. I've checked that there's no grout sticking out of the joins. I've swept around the edge of the arcs and the door and the window. And so now I'm ready to just give it all a sponge off and start grouting. Okay, the one on the left went yellow after one day of picking, from green like that to yellow. Just want to point out where these bananas branch off. It's like a sort of a, you know, like a mouth type look to it, and the bananas branch off that.
Sort of struggled beyond 2000 last prep, but Jay's confident he can get further. Is it a case of horse maturing, getting a bit older?
The number of consecutive tests that he played after his debut, which was a record for a fast bowler for Australia. The other thing was the number of times he gets man of the match, Brad. And that his strike rate is second only to Shane Keith Warne, which gives him an indication of, when he gets it right, the impact that he can have on the game.
Well, have a look at Mitchell Johnson's test record. It is unbelievably good.
Yes.
Unbelievably good with bat and ball. But it's very, what you say, is right, he's a match winner. And if you
Okay, just a tip about grouting. This grout goes off faster than you might think. You want to keep it under control. I'm only mixing up a little bit in the bowl, but as soon as the grout hits the tiles, it starts to dry and it starts to go off. So I recommend mixing up about half of a bowl this size, putting it on the wall, and then once it's all on the wall, give it a quick sponge just to get it all smooth. You don't want to lose control of it. So I've made a start now, and it's just the bottom half of the job to be done. Okay, so I've just applied the grout. I just put it on the tray like that and put it in the joins. And now once I've used that much up, then I go ahead and just give it a light sponge, make sure it's all under control. As you can see, some places are starting to go hard already. And you can see there that by sponging it off while it's still wet, after you've put it on, it provides a good finish. So there's no need to let it go hard or to wait after you've put it on. And don't forget, don't mix up too much. I've only mixed up half a bowl at a time.
Coffs Harbour Police says shark attacks in the area are rare.
It's not one of our main tourist beaches. It's not heavily populated. It's more of a locals' back beach. It's quite secluded.
So I'm just getting the grout into the join now, just both directions, just making sure there's no air bubbles. And I clean off the excess on the side, like so. These are big tiles, so I only need to work around the edge where the gap is between the tiles. Just work in both directions. Make sure there's no holes, air pockets, air bubbles. Wipe the grout off from the edges. Like so.
Leaving film, and it's pretty, so we've got a mixture of it's the Warramoo, We're all fire service and friends with Valley Heights. We're all fire service and friends. And they call me a 2023 that I think because there's about 20 batsmen on each side. And they earlier, before the match started, they called me the extra ashes.
Obviously, the shower base is a very important thing to grout. So I'm working as much grout as I possibly can into this area above the shower base, both with my finger. I've also got this tool that acts as a finger. It's got a rubber end, so I'm using all techniques, as many techniques as possible, just to make sure that I'm working this grout in on top of the shower base here.
Well, hopefully pile on the runs in the next two sessions, Pete. There's plenty of time left. There's still 65 overs left in the day. So Tasmanian be looking to put the foot down the next couple of sessions and build up.
He hasn't been as much in the problems that I thought he might have been. He's went straight into the trees again. He must have something out there that he wants to explore again, because yesterday he was in the trees. He somehow got out and managed to save par. But I thought yesterday he needed a change. That's putting the cart before the horse, Pat. Actually, I heard that you and Deb talking about Pat Cummins. He actually returned to great cricket yesterday. He played with his favourite club. He actually played a second grade game. He batted. Only got
the A Ground, Western Australia, taking on Queensland, called the Middle Match with the lads.
We're about three quarters of an hour into the morning here on day three. 112 overs due for today and tomorrow to make up for the lost time on day one. And good news for the Warriors.
Okay, so just give it a last sponge off, and that is finished. Okay, so that is 10 hours. 10 hours work, preparation, and grouting to complete the bathroom. So yeah, I would recommend working from the top and working down, as well as just mixing up just a little bit in a small bowl and just working it in between the tiles and sponging off straight away once you've used about a good handful. Don't mix up too much and keep it under control.